say you want a revolution. Well, you know, we all want it.
When I think particularly of television punditry, which I have been doing and being paid for, because why in my right mind would I do it otherwise? For most of the last 20 years, I would think of hair extensions and breast implants would be sort of ahead on the list, but very similar. I thought I would tell you two stories that sort of capture my experience and what I've learned in 20 years of working for, I think, every network at some point in time. And neither of these stories, I should say in advance, are about Fox News, for whom I've worked for the last 9 years. The first one was some years ago. I got a call. And the most important thing, I think, in television punditry is time. That is, are you available at 3? Because most television punditry is live. And it doesn't matter how knowledgeable, talented, or good-looking you are if you're not available. So the first question they always ask you is, are you free at 3? Not what the subject is. Oftentimes I go on without knowing what the subject is, but I have learned that that's less important than making sure you have makeup. So they called me one day and they said, are you free at 3? I said, 3, I'm free at 3. Good. Okay, now check one off the list. Great, she says. Well, can you do it? I said, well, maybe. What's it? She said, affirmative action. I said, oh. This is the time, it was a very hot issue in California. She said to me, what's your position? She said, I heard you were against affirmative action. I said, well, that's not exactly right. I said, I am against blanket quota programs. On the other hand, I think that where, I teach this stuff, where there's a past history of discrimination or a compelling case for diversity, then affirmative action should be allowed. She said, that makes perfect sense. I said, it's good because it's the law of the land. She said, great. Would you say you are for or against affirmative action? I said, well, I would say I am against affirmative action, except in those limited cases when I am for it. I said, well, to put it another way, I am for it, except when I'm against it. She said, that's fine, because you're the first person I've called. You're our top choice. She says, and you're free at 3. She says, would you say you are for affirmative action? I said, should we do it again? She said, no. She said, just pick one. I said, well, I can't exactly pick one because I am for it some of the time and against it some of the time. She said, that's a problem. I said, why is it a problem? She said, because we're not having 3 guests. We're only having 2 guests. One, for, and one, against. And she needed to know which column to put me in. And I said, well, I'm not in either column. She said, that's really too bad because you're free at 3. I said, exactly. And what ended up happening, of course, because I did turn the TV on at 3, and my position is, was, and still is the law of the land, and supported by 97% of the country, was they had, as usual, the whackball on the left, who said, I'm for affirmative action all the time, in any circumstance, you know, whatever, because of slavery, etc. And the whackball on the right, who said, I don't care if there's never a black in the medical school class and no blacks on LAPD, we should never have affirmative action. And the whackball on the left yelled at the whackball on the right for 5 minutes. And they had what in television passes as a really good segment. And they said to me, we'll call you another time when you have a position. So the moral of this story is, if you really want to be on television, and this is what you have to think about, you will be asked to take ridiculous positions. And one of the questions you have to ask yourself, I always get nervous. When I saw the title of this panel, I thought to myself, oh God, a room full of blondes with hair extensions who have never done anything and want to be pundits. Spare me, right? I said to Gary, we don't have enough blondes in this room, or Cassandra, with hair extensions. How are they going to become pundits? You have to ask yourself, at what cost and as what? You know, are you going to go on and say what you think? or are you going to go on and play a pre-designed role? I got a call on Elliot Spitzer this week. Elliot's a former student of mine, so I got a number of these, you know, what...
Did you really teach him criminal law?
Yeah, great job, I did. Right? I was going to go on about that. But I did get one call saying, could you come on to say how this scandal is good for Hillary? I said, well, I'm free at 3, but it's not good for Hillary. They said, yeah, but we're looking for someone who will say that it's good for Hillary. And I said, what you have to say sometimes, I said, keep looking, right? You have to decide. Now, I am one of those who believes in the old-fashioned rule that you shouldn't appear on television to talk about something you know nothing about. But this is an old-fashioned rule not followed by most people. I had an experience where I got a call. Different network, still not Fox. They said to me, are you free at 3? So I would say, ah, I'm free at 3. They said, could you come on? Chris Cox was at the time the chairman of a subcommittee that had just done an investigation into China and some kind of deceptive, some sales of munition systems or something. I said, that happens to be a topic about which I know absolutely nothing. They said, well, but you're really good on TV. I said, well, that may be. They said, do you know Chris Cox? I said, I went to law school with Chris Cox. They said, you're free at 3, and you went to law school with Chris Cox? The woman said, we'll take you. I said, what are you going to take me to do? She said, we'll think of something. And sure enough, I was being paid by the appearance at the time. So I thought to myself, wow, they want to take me. Sure enough, I went on, they showed a picture of Chris Cox, they said, Chris Cox has an important report up today, and we have one of his good friends from law school to talk about it. I said, well, here I am, hi, he was nice in law school, you know, I mean, what are you going to say, right? The point is, the people at the other end of the line, and this is off the record, are not always rocket scientists. Okay? And what they want are people who are good on television. This is what television is about. You will never get in trouble for booking somebody who is lively, energetic, has strong views, and hair extensions. So, understanding that no one listens to TV, they look at TV. I think the bottom line for anybody who wants to be a pundit is ask yourself a fundamental question. Why? Right? And what do you want to do with it? I see people make fools of themselves every single day because they are so desperate to be on television. They go on about topics they know nothing about, saying stupid things and getting eaten for lunch by the hosts. That's why I have my fundamental rule. If I don't know more about the subject than the person asking me the questions, I probably shouldn't be on that subject. And so my own view is, if it works for you, do it. But if it smells fishy, there's a very easy answer. I'm not free at 3. Thank you very much.
Say you want a revolution. Well, you know, we all want to change the world. You tell me that it's evolution. Well, you know, we all want to change the world. But when you talk about destruction, don't you know that you can count me out? Don't you know it's gonna be alright? All right.